Hello and welcome to week 3 unit 2 business configuration deep dive. My name is Babulal Limba and this unit I will talk about the further aspects of business configuration which enables the user to create additional content as their business need changes or enhancement is required. Remember, we saw the business option for purchase order approval in the last unit. Upon scoping this option, a fine tuning activity purchase order approval filters is available for users to configure. In this activity, user can specify if the purchase order should go for approval to the buyer responsible or creator of the purchase order or not. Based on the data maintained in this activity, the approval process of the purchase order is shaped. So now we will take a deep dive into how to provide such a fine tuning activity. Let's move on. Let's talk about business configuration object. We shall start with an object called business configuration object, in short BCO. BCO is similar to business object entity that has a structure comprised of a key, attributes and an inbuilt query to read the data stored in the BCO. The object is used as a basis to create business configuration content using BC sets, delivering predefined contents and BC views enabling users to create additional content on top of what is delivered. BCOs delivered by SAP can be used to create BC content. Also, you can create custom BCOs as per the requirement to deliver your content. Please note that you work on standard BCOs only in partner development tenant and not on customer tenant. Apart from delivering business configuration content, a custom BCO can be used to define a code list type which can be manipulated by the end users in fine tuning. This gives the flexibility of adding or removing values from drop-down fields as per the requirement. A BCO is represented by a file extension .bco in the solution. Business configuration set. Next, you should understand what a business configuration set is. A BC set, in short, is used to define the values for the attributes of BCO, and these values becomes the part of pre-delivered content to the end users. So, you can create BC sets on custom BCOs to deliver the content, and while defining the content, you can also control the properties of your content by allowing or restricting to delete or add additional values by the end users. You might have the requirement to deliver some content on standard SAP BCOs, and hence BC sets can be created on top of standard BCOs. For example, you want to provide the text content for some country. However, please note it is only possible in partner development tenant. Another point to note here is that you cannot create business configuration sets on standard BCOs in solution template. A file extension with extension .bcc represents a BC set in your solution. And the last content type for this unit is BC view. BC view represents the fine tuning activity UI that shows you the business configuration content provided by the BC set. So, it is a UI component, and based on the BCO in your solution, please note that it cannot be based on the standard BCO. The fine tuning provides the end user a possibility to view the predefined content, create, delete, or change the business configuration content. For example, if a code list type is delivered using a BCO, then a fine tuning activity can be provided to enable users to enhance the code list as per the need. End users can access your fine tuning activity from the business configuration work center, and hence you need to assign your fine tuning BC view to the business configuration work center. As mentioned earlier, a BC view is represented as a UI component with extension .UI component in the add-on solution. Once your business configuration content, BCO, BC set and BC view are ready, the content needs to be assigned to the business configuration option that we discussed in the last unit, so that the content is available in the tenant when the option is scoped. After assigning the business configuration content to BC option, scope the option and test your business configuration content. It is also important to understand the maintenance aspects of business configuration content. Once the add-on is in maintenance mode, there are restrictions to change the business configuration content. Hence, It is important to know these restrictions so that you prepare the content in right way and do not face challenges later. To highlight a few scenarios, in business configuration option, for example, you cannot change the mandatory flag which is available for scoping, and you cannot change the anchor. Once the BCO is delivered, you cannot change or delete the fields defined in the BCO. However, adding new fields are allowed. In business configuration set, you cannot delete the rows, the data that you provided, but you can add more in the maintenance mode. So let me now demonstrate the same with our user story. Assume the customer needs an option to decide if the ID of the job should be created manually or automatically. By default, it is manually entered. Also, when customers choose to create job IDs automatically, the job ID should be prefixed based on employment type. So let's go into the system and do it. So here my add-on is open. You can see the Cloud Application Studio. So the add-on open SAP underscore demo is now open. Right click on it, add a new item. We'll create a business configuration object first. So select a business configuration object and provide an appropriate name for the business configuration object. I would provide number derivation job ID. Add it and now provide the short description for the business configuration object. So number derivation for job ID. Well, there is an option below code list data type, whether you want to deliver this BCO as a code list data type. It by default it is selected. I would not like this. I will remove it and go to next. For the R scenario, we will do something else. So here you see this. Now you define the structure for the BCO. So you specify the field name. The first field name, my field name is EMP type, which basically means the employment type. I would like to keep it as a key field. This is my key for this entity, and the data type is the data type from my add-on which I have created for employment type code. Okay, and it is also mandatory to be specified. Of course, it's a key. Then we go to the next row, add one more field called as prefix. Let's give the name prefix for it. It's an attribute of type text with 40 characters. I make it mandatory. And one more we will add it for our scenario. Let's call it separator. So basically this will separate your employment type and the job ID by a character and say mandatory. So this is how I define my business configuration object attributes. So I have three attributes and all are mandatory. Now with this, let's move on to the next step in the wizard, which is the final step. Here I can review the what data I have entered, everything fine, click on finish, else you can go back and come back and review and finish the activity. Once you finish, a BCO is created, as you can see here, as again a red bubble means it's inactive. So you have to right click and say activate, so it will activate the business configuration object. Okay, so it takes a while to activate the object. Once it is activated, we can do the follow on things. Yes, so now we can see a message, item acted successfully. Now create a business configuration view on top of this. So let's specify the name for the view. So I will call it job number view, job number view. Okay, and it is based on the business configuration object that I just created by default. Okay. And you can see the UI component file is created. Double click on it and then it will open in the UI designer. Here we will see the UI layout of my business configuration view. You will always get this pop up once you open a UI component in designer, and it loads. So let's assign this business configuration view to my business configuration work center, as I mentioned. So my business configuration work center is in my folder SAP BYD application UI, BC tools. Okay, and then work center, expand the work center, and let's find the implementation projects work center view. here we go, double click on it so that it opens. So then once it opens, we will assign our BC view to this WorkCenter view. So for that, you have to go to Extensibility Explorer, select the anchor, and after selecting the anchor, you can see the operations below, assign component to view, right, click on it, and now let's select the component which I want to assign to this WorkCenter view. It is under my BC folder of the add-on. So my add-on BC folder is here, click on SRC, and now you can see the view over there. Okay. So I have now assigned the component, apply the changes for it. Once applied, the change transaction is created, and it says the change transaction will be active once you activate the solution, once you activate the UI. So click on activate, and it's activated. I will also activate the my business configuration view just to be sure that nothing goes wrong. Well, it is activated now, done. Now, yeah, so now the next step would be to again select my BCO and right click and say create a business configuration set. Now we will provide the pre-delivered content for this business configuration here. So I would name it, and I am, this BC set is based on the business configuration object of the custom add-on, not from SAP. As you can see in the first option, let me give a description, number, definition for job ID. Yeah, so click next, we'll go to the next step of the wizard, step 2, and this is the screen where you can specify the values of your attributes which you defined in the business configuration object. I have marked the values to be added in the values can be added in fine tuning, which means you can add more values in the fine tuning by the business user, but pre-delivered values I will specify here. So for example, part time, if the part time employment type is part time, I would say prefix is PT separated by hyphen, and say these values can be deleted later on by the business user in the fine tuning. Similarly, I will specify for other employment types, and I will set the same setting that the value can be deleted in the fine tuning by the end user. So let's define this 3 rows at least. Okay, so this is the data that we would see on the UI in our fine tuning activity, because this is what we are delivering. So this is the review screen as usual at the end of the wizard, where you can review your data. Everything is okay, looks fine, finish, and as I mentioned, it will create a .bcc file in your add-on solution. Here we go, job number.bcc. So that's the file we have to activate now, so that the runtime objects are generated in the backend. Okay, it's activating. We'll wait for a moment. Okay, we have got the message, item activated successfully. Now, once the item is activated successfully, we have prepared all 3 objects, and BCO, BC set, and BC view. Now I will go to the bark element, and now I will provide a new option in the bark element, a new question which says that do you want to use automatic job ID numbering or manually. So I create a BC option for that under the same BC topic which we did in the last unit. So call it number set, a small description for this business option. So this is an option to select automatic job ID. So now we have an option here, you see visible in fine tuning and visible in scoping. Okay, let me specify for the overview, and overview is, as I mentioned earlier, it's the documentation that you provide for the business option, which is important for the business users to understand what does it mean. Okay, and now I will provide a scoping question. So this option will be visible in scoping, and I'm not marking it mandatory because it's not a mandatory thing to scope your solution. So once you visit this question and scope it, then it will be scoped only. I think see, and we will put it at the anchor job search application that we created. We see OK button is not disabled, probably we are missing something. I think we have still not specified all the parameters. So we'll also specify visible in fine tuning this option, which means now this business option has an associated fine tuning activity which should be seen by the business users. So just define a description for it, define prefix for job ID. Yeah, we missed the relevance, so just mention the relevance as well, and now the OK is active. So now you see we have a new content which is a job number BC set, and we have to connect it to the new business option that we created, number set. So now it is under this, click next and review every all the content is now assigned to the business option, and we are good to go ahead. Okay, so the business adaptation catalog is now inactive because we did changes. Let's activate it. So once it is active, we will be able to then test our functionality. So now, okay, we'll create a small script file for the job profile business object, which is basically on the before save event. Okay, so I just add a script file before save, and in this file I will put a small piece of code which basically will help you to fetch an automatic number for the job ID. So this I will copy paste it, this is available in your exercises, you can have a look at it, and here you can see the code. So I define a number range object record, and I will draw the number from it, and I copy it into my attribute job ID string. And then you can see the below what I am doing is I am adding a select, creating a selection parameter using the query of the business configuration object, and I am firing that query with the parameter employment type. So once I get the employment type from my pre-delivered BCO content, I would fetch the prefix and the separator and then use it to generate the job ID. So I will concatenate the job ID with the prefix and the separator to get the final job ID. So I activate the script file. I hope so you have understood the logic that we are doing here. So we are just drawing a new number and concatenating it with the data called prefix and the separator from the BC set and appending them together to create a job ID. So now everything is active in the system. Once this is done, what I would do is deploy the business configuration so that all changes what I did are now deployed. And you can see below this my solutions view the step 1 of 4 which is going on, and here you will see a successful message once the business configuration is deployed successfully. It might take a moment here. So yeah, business configuration is now successfully deployed. Here we go into the business configuration by the UI now, and let's see, we'll scope this option first, the new option, whether you want to generate the job ID automatically, and then we will see whether it generates us the job ID automatically or not. So you remember the steps from the last unit, select the implementation project, click edit project scope, and we will move on to the fourth step here, which is questions. Nothing to do until then, just keep moving. So scoping, we have nothing to do because we have already scoped the business topic. It's a new business option which is available in the questions. Let's go to the business area human resources, and then I will go to personnel administration and select my business topic job search application, and you see a different one more business option. Do you want the job ID to be determined automatically? I would say yes, I want to determine it automatically, and click next to finish this guided activity. Well, everything is okay, so you click on finish. This again, as I mentioned, it deploys the business configuration changes in the background. We will wait for them to finish, and we reach the confirmation step, which means we are done, close. So this is done. Now let's go ahead and test what we have developed. Let's log in again to the system so that the business configuration changes which we made are effective for the user when they log in. I am logging in as a key user. At the key user here is also of role HR manager, who is supposed to create jobs in the system. So the key user basically will then create a job here, and while defining the job we will see whether the job ID is created automatically or not. Okay, meanwhile we will also see our fine tuning activity that we developed and delivered, which is a BC view. So let us search our fine tuning activity. Job ID, it has the text job ID, so let us put it, and you see the first one, option to select automatic job ID. This is the fine tuning activity we created, and it should show the pre-delivered content that we had. And here you see all the content which we defined in the BC set: full time, contract, part time, prefix, and the separated by field. You can add more values, copy or delete, as we have defined the settings in the add-on. Let's close it and go to the real testing of the functionality now. Okay, so I will move to job profile view, and let me create a new job here. So I create a new job and I will specify the title. I will not specify the job ID because this is what I am expecting to be automatically filled on my before save event. Okay, specify the parameters, the work area, and let's save. Here we go. So the next number that is drawn is 84, and it is prefixed with PT, and there is a separator hyphen in between. So that's what we wanted to do. We have achieved through the business configuration content. So we are reading the content, business configuration content, through a query, and then putting it in to derive the job ID automatically. So that's it, the end of the demo. So let's move on to the slides. So having demonstrated the creation of business configuration content, we come to an end of this unit. Let's have a quick recap of what we touched upon in this unit. We created a business configuration object for our internal job search scenario. We defined a BC set on this BCO that provides the prefix for job IDs. Defined a BC view that allows users to define prefixes for more employment types. Assigned the BC set to the BC option, that means that we want the content to be active only when the BC option is selected. Also highlighted the properties of BC objects in the maintenance mode, which is important to remember. I hope the session of business configuration details was useful to you. Please try the scenario with hands-on experience for this unit. Have a great day. Thank you. See you in the next unit. Bye-bye.